right, gentlemen, let's get on with it. Which of us will write our Declaration of Independence?
Mr. Adams, I say you should write it. To your legal mind and brilliance we defer.
Is that so? Well, if I'm the one to do it, they'll run their quill pens through it. I'm obnoxious and disliked, you know that, sir.
Yes, I know.
But I say you should write it, Franklin. Yes, you.
Hell no.
Yes, you, Dr. Franklin. You,
but,
you,
but,
you.
But, Mr. Adams, but, Mr. Adams, the things I write are only light extemporanea. I won't put politics on paper, it's a mania. So I refuse to use the pen in Pennsylvania.
Pennsylvania, Pennsylvania, refuse to use the pen.
Mr. Sherman, I say you should write it. You are never controversial, as it were.
That is true.
Whereas if I'm the one to do it, they'll run their quill pens through it. I'm obnoxious and disliked, you know that, sir.
Yes, I do.
Then I say you should write it, Roger. Yes, you.
Good heavens, no.
Yes, you, Roger Sherman. You,
but,
you,
but,
you.
But, Mr. Adams, but, Mr. Adams, I cannot write with any style of proper etiquette. I don't know a participle from a predicate. I am just a simple cobbler from Connecticut.
Connecticut, Connecticut, a simple cobbler me.
Mr. Livingston, maybe you should write it. You have many friends and you're a diplomat.
Oh, that word.
Whereas if I'm the one to do it, they'll run their quill pens through it.
He's obnoxious and disliked, did you know that?
I hadn't heard.
So I say you should write it, Robert. Yes, you.
Not me.